Ivan Chaparinov scores a critical victory in round 8 of the Gibraltar Masters against Noel Struder. He joins us in our studio. Ivan, good to have you back in our studio after,
yes,
like you said, what could have been a Grunfield this time but turned out to be a King's Indian.
Yeah, I decided to change because Grunfield is very drawish line also. We see that Vacher every time they're making draw to him. So this time today I wanted to play more aggressive game because okay, I need to win, so
it's a very
That's why I decided to play King's Indian.
It's a very critical moment in the tournament to also try to take your chances.
Yeah, actually after Battle of Sixes, I played only one move with F5. After that, I lost one game, I made one draw. So, okay, I want to turn the things back to normal.
You took some time to recover from the Battle of the Sexes.
Yeah, I needed 3 days. So, okay, here we have this position that, okay, I'm doing quite okay with black because I attack only four, but the point is that he repeats. And actually, I cannot escape because if I played knight e4, but okay, queen h4 is the, I believe, is the best move, and simply make a draw. Because in the game, I'm not sure if I'm much worse, but this position is very dangerous because now queen h4 is just rook f4.
Yes.
So I have only move queen h5. Actually, I calculated all of this. The point is that, okay, knight g3 probably he needs to play it, queen h4. And now he had some options. For example, he had this very interesting move. But I think I survive with this one.
And the knight doesn't really have a very
Yeah, now he can take here and still looks very unpleasant because if gf, then knight f5. But I have very strong move here, rook e8, I was calculating. And I think black is fine because if he takes, I just take rook back and I don't see any
dangerous jumps. I have to ask you, so here you knew that you had this repetition and you probably felt it was...
I simply calculated all this line. I didn't see that I'm lost, so
okay.
Maybe I'm slightly worse, but I mean, I can definitely play, so...
But you felt that it could be slightly worse for you, but you wanted to take a chance.
Yes,
here.
But actually, I'm not sure about this position because, okay, I saw this rook e4, and okay, here I thought a little bit because he played very fast rook e4, and okay, I thought that black should be fine. I mean, I didn't see why I'm worse, but the point is, okay, of course he wants queen d5, and the only thing that I should avoid is to take queen d5 cd, you know?
With this e6 pawn.
Yeah, because here
very
also black, white can very easy go wrong, because the pawn is weak, and I have very simple pawn, rook e8, bishop e5 at some point, and how it happened actually, that he played bad immediately, but I think it's not so clear, maybe here, okay, here I had very good move also, this one, but I thought it would be a draw. He can go and bishop e3, rook e3, and
everything
rook
gets traded.
I mean, maybe this is the strongest one and black is fine, but I mean, okay, I still want to play a win, so queen f5, queen d5, and I think here he made a crucial mistake. He should have played in g4 probably. The point is that I cannot take because of bishop goes back, bishop f2. And okay, I need to play queen f6, and I still think black is probably can defend, but I mean, white is not worse because bishop f2 now or something. I don't have bishop e5 because, for example, if you play immediately bishop f2, I can go bishop e5, then just winning the pawn.
The e6 pawn, but he actually collapsed at this moment with
queen
c6. Yeah,
because g4 is only move, I believe. Because
and
I
not so easy to play as
not
well.
Not so easy. He played queen c6 immediately, but okay, before playing, I think, queen c5, I saw all this line, which is very forced, and I saw that I'm just probably winning. Or not winning, but much better. Bishop.
Do you think he missed this idea, or what happened here?
I'm not sure, but okay. It's not easy with white also. I mean, if you don't play here g4, I mean, if you just take, and then I just...
The e-pawn is very, very weak.
I mean, it's not easy. He should play g4, but it's not easy. So he went for this one, maybe hoping for some draw, but okay, he probably missed this one, I don't know. But I still believe the position is not clear after here. I think rook e7. Okay, of course, this is very nice tactic that if he takes here, king f2, I just take rook e3.
And f4.
Yeah, so this is the whole point of the combination,
yeah,
actually.
Yeah, it's nice.
Yes, but here I think this end game, after we reach this position, I don't think white is lost. I mean, maybe it's even draw, I don't know. Because he took, and I played queen c2 because he didn't like to play king c6 because of bishop f2. Maybe queen c2, then maybe c5. Takes rook e5.
Rook e5.
It's very close to draw.
Yeah.
So that's why I played queen c2, and he played, I mean, very
If in this
move.
Position, white is able to trade off all the pawns on
yes.
this side, he should be able to hold.
Yeah, now he
then
takes this one, and maybe if he can somehow go to f3, it should be a draw.
Right.
So even sometimes without bishop, you know, this position, I mean, if you take one pawn, h7 or something, it should be a draw. So here, queen c2, yeah, he played rook a1, very passive move. I think, okay, he should have played here and rook e3. And I'm not entirely sure if this is winning, because he has, I mean, a lot of, maybe it's 50-50, or I win or it's draw. I mean, I don't think black is so winning.
Would you play a4 here, or would you bring the king first?
I'm not sure, maybe I bring the king, but it's not clear, because he plays rook f3 and just stays, so.
But a pleasant position for you to play and keep on trying to.
Even if I, for example, if I change this one pawn for these two pawns, it's also not so clear if it's winning, because he has some kind of blockade, no? So,
but then after a4, just the final blunder here was taking this.
Yeah, I don't know why he could have still played probably what I thought. Maybe just war story. Maybe bishop f2, I thought something. It could be 2. Yeah, it should be just.
And now e3 is coming as well.
Yeah, here it's after rook a1, a4, maybe he just collapses.
It collapses. Yeah. You know, hearing you analyze this game, one gets the feeling that at many situations, you had safer options, knowing that maybe they were better, but you chose riskier moves, maybe slightly worse.
Today I decided to play because, okay, obviously he's not a bad player, but I'm kind of stronger, so my plan was just to play for win and to see what happened. And, okay, of course, I didn't want to risk too much, but simply at that point when I played this move, this critical move, knight e4, I didn't believe that white is better or something.
Okay.
I mean, maybe slightly, but it's, I mean, it's not clear.
Right, well, two more games left. Approach going into the next two rounds, aggressive play or?
Depends on who I'm playing and how I feel, but okay, of course I need to win some more games.
Yes. Yeah. All right, we wish you all the best for that, and it's always a pleasure to have you with us
here.
Thank you, Ivan. So.